Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, May 29th, we'll talk about Simon the sorcerer, a bad man from the Bible. You must be wondering, are they bad people also in the Bible? Yes, they are quoted in the Bible. They are about them, God told about them, because by reading about them, we should correct ourselves. So we'll talk about Simon the sorcerer. Acts 8:20 says, there's a sentence there, your money perished with you because you thought that the gift of God could be purchased. This is a curse made by Peter to Simon. Simon was a sorcerer who had professed his faith in Jesus Christ after he heard Philip's preaching and got baptized. He continued following Philip and was amazed at the miracles he was doing and how Holy Spirit was coming upon people on whom Peter and John laid hands. Simon offered the apostles money to give him the power that anyone on whom he laid his hands would receive the Holy Spirit. You should read that chapter 8, 8th chapter 19, it's written like that. And when Peter heard his request, he was very angry with him and responded in the above manner. Peter was shocked to see him doing this. He was shocked to hear his words, and he got very angry because he was trying to buy the Holy Spirit power. Simon's quest to buy the ability to impact the power of the Spirit was his obvious sin. Including a more subtle evil was his desire to use the power of God for his own gain. That's what our present preachers, some of them, are doing. The word simony, which is the buying and selling of church offices and influences, originates there here. Though Simon was temporarily influenced by Philip's preaching and was baptized, he was not transformed. There are some incidents like this recorded in the Bible so that they could be examples to us. Paul in 1 Corinthians 10:11 says that they were written down as warnings for us on whom the culmination of the ages has come. At the end times, we should be very careful about this. We'll see some qualities in him which we shouldn't have. First is, his name was Simon, which means hearer. He just heard the word of God but didn't do accordingly. Like James 1:22 says, don't be doers, hearers only, be doers, he says. Second one is, he was a sorcerer, which means deceiver, and continued to be the same. Sorcerers, they deceive people. They say something and they make us feel that that something is there in front of us. Third is, he believed and got baptized but not transformed. Fourth is, his heart was deceitful and didn't change. In Jeremiah 17:9, it's written that the heart is deceitful above all things and beyond cure. Only God can cure it. Fifth is, he was poisoned by bitterness and bound by iniquity. That's what was written about him in 8:23. Our churches are full of such people. Beware. Let's pray. Lord, please help us not to be Simons. Lord, help us to be obedient to your word. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen.